Hey guys, Tabs McCaffrey here from the Urban Goddess Shop. Welcome back. So excited to have you guys here today, and we are gonna do a what sold. I'm running a little bit behind, so this is the what sold from 2 weeks ago, and then I'm gonna do last week's before the weekend this week. Oh my gosh, that's a lot of weeks. Anyways, rather than doing one big one, I'm still gonna split it up because we had an epic week of sales. If you wanna hear more, you like reseller content, give us a thumbs up. If you wanna follow us on our journey, we are still pretty new at clothing reselling. Make sure you hit subscribe and then join along. All right. So let's get started. If you don't know me, my name is Tabs McCaffrey. I'm a mom, a wife, and I have two girls. And my two girls help thrift with me and run the business. My oldest likes to help with the thrifting, and my youngest likes to help with the packaging and shipping. If you ever get a box from me and it says Poshmail, chances are my youngest wrote that on there. Also, if you stay till the end, I have two tips that I'm gonna give you to increase your sales and hopefully help you grow your posh closet. All right, so let's get started. I'm gonna pull this up on my phone because it's the easiest. I'm doing posh sales for the week of October 12th to 18th. We had a really good week, and I think part of it was here in Canada, it was Thanksgiving weekend. So I think a lot of people were home, they were shopping a bit more, they were traveling, maybe spending some more time on their phone through their travels or while they were at families after supper, things like that. I'm not really sure. But anyways, it was a great week. On Poshmark, we sold $1,274 worth. So this is a gross sales, not a net. Keep in mind, we do majority of our sourcing through the Goodwill bins. So our costs are relatively low. I'm not gonna go through individual costs for items because that is just too much work. I think just for anyone who's running their Poshmark business, you want to make sure that your cost of goods are as low as possible. So my goal is to be less than $10 if I'm going out thrifting. Typically when I'm going to a thrift store outside of my bins haul, I'm looking for boots, jackets, and jeans. Those are my top things. Sometimes sweaters, but I see the biggest return on boots, jackets, and jeans. I don't find as many brand name items in those categories to go into my closet when I'm at the bins, so I definitely will rely on my local thrift stores. Let's go for it. So on eBay, we had $0 in sales. We do sell on a couple other platforms, but since we kind of switched over to Poshmark, I haven't really been focusing on any other platforms because I can't do all of this and work a full-time job. So I should throw it out there. We are part-time resellers. I work a full-time job. My oldest daughter works a full-time job. My youngest goes to school. My husband works. So we are completely running this in our spare time. We're mostly gone on weekends. We pretty much run this Monday to Thursday outside of our work hours. I know, crazy. I can't believe the amount of sales we got this week. And this just shows to people that you can do this part-time and you can make money running a posh closet. All right, so let's go into a few statistics. Our single sales, we had 16 single sales. We had 16 bundle sales. And our bundles typically were I think the most was a 6-item bundle. I could be wrong, but we'll go through that when I go through all the bundles separately. Total packages shipped out was 32, and we sent 60 items. So I kind of divided it just to see what our average items per day that we're leaving, and it was like 8.5. So we could round up to 9 items a day. Now, if I were to try and figure out what I need to list, I have to list at minimum 60 items to sustain the growth or to sustain our sales. So keep that in mind that if you have a great week and you sell a ton of stuff, guess what? You got to list some more items. You have to replenish that stock. I know that I have to list at least 70 to 80 items to keep that kind of growth. I'm gonna go over the week. Let's start what sold for the week of October 12th to 18th. So starting on the 12th, and I'm gonna use my phone, so if I'm looking down, that's what I'm doing, trying to search it up. Come on. The first item to sell was a Western fleece long sleeve button jacket in a small, and this sold for $22. I'm also gonna show everything, you probably saw it, it's gonna pop up on the screen here. Maybe I'll move over a little bit, let some room. The other thing that we sold, this is such a cool item. I sold a Judith Jack gold tone vintage dog leather belt. So I knew nothing about this, and I only picked it up because it was an animal. Anytime I see animal anything and I think it's kind of quirky, I pick it up. I love it, and therefore I hope that someone else will love it. Sometimes it surprises me where I think this is like so weird. I don't know if anyone will. and it always sells so quick. So this was one of those items, and I didn't know anything about Judas Jack. Search them on Google, go on eBay, check them out. I cannot believe how much her items sell for. Such a cool belt designer. The next thing that sold was a Joseph Ribkoff. I always struggle with this one, and I say it to myself every time I pick up a tag. I'm like, Joseph Ribkoff. How do I pronounce that right? Anyways, black white striped jacket in a size 8. I was at Valley Village in Medicine Hat, Alberta, way back in summer. They had a whole pile of this Joseph Ribkoff items, I guess I should say. And I picked them all up thinking, oh my gosh, these are like super high designer, they're worth so much money. And I was so excited, but they didn't sell very well in my closet. I definitely will be selective. I find Joseph Ribkoff unique items, so items that are floral or have like a fancy kind of print sell really well, but the things that are just black and white and plain, I did not get a good return on investment. This was also before I was going to the bins. Now, I will only buy them if I am paying less than $5 an item. So the next was a bundle, and this was a vintage grandpa knit sweater, oversized medium. I don't really have a brand. It was definitely one of those old vintagey kind of labels. And I also sold a vintage higher state fleece sweater, oversized in medium, and this one sold for $25. This bundle sold for $40. Usually when I say oversized, because it's a men's sizing, I kind of just compare to what average sizes are for sweaters. Next was a pink red lace bralette padded cup and extra small. I sold this for $10. I think it was actually listed higher. She sent me an offer and I was like, yeah, cool, I'll sell it for $10. The next bundle sold for $32, and this was an RW Co. knit sleeveless sweater top in large. She also bundled this with a white sheer lace embroidered shawl. I put it as a one size. I had it listed for $16. I was totally cool with what that bundle sold for. Next was another bundle. This one sold for $60. It had a fur collar denim trucker jacket jean. I worded this awful. Fur collar, denim, trucker, jean jacket in a medium. This was not a brand. Like, it was a no-name brand. This is proof that you don't need brand names to sell anything in your closet. It was just a style that I knew people were looking out for this fall, so I thought it would be a good item. I ended up with two of these in my last bins haul, so I was pumped. This was the first one to sell. The other item in this bundle that sold was the Jeffrey Campbell snakeskin all-man booties, and those were at a 9.5. They were really unique, but I was happy they went to someone. They're beautiful shoes. I hope she enjoys them. Next was another bundle. This one sold for $30. It was a Gap men's utility cargo jacket in large and a men's gray long sleeve full length dress coat. These were two items. I don't have a lot of luck with men's clothing in my closet, and I've heard people in the States talking that they have good luck with their men's. I don't know if it's because it's in Canada and maybe the men's side isn't as grown. I could be wrong. If you have good luck and you're here in Canada, please drop a comment. I'd love to know. So this bundle sold for $30, and that lady got two jackets. My earnings were $20 after fees, $20.50. I was really just happy to get the items out and moving, so $10, whatever, profit, it's fine. I'll live. They're just not taking up room in my inventory anymore. All right. So the next one was an EZE graphic long sleeve sweater in medium. This was from my personal closet. I wore it over the summer and just kind of had some new things come into my closet from thrifting and knew that I wasn't going to wear it as much, so I kind of threw it in there. I also had a pair of vintage naturalizer brown leather woven flats in a size 7, and they hadn't been worn very much, but there was some issues with the sole. It was kind of lifting, so I was just very transparent about it, took good pictures, said there's a bit of sole issues, but if you bought a Dr. Scholl's and slid it in, that would fix that. And she bought that bundle. Oh my gosh, okay, it was a $75 bundle, sorry, and I'm gonna keep going. She also got a hot pink graphic short sleeve tee in medium. This was a Saskatchewan one. It was called the Saskatchewan Flatlanders or something. Anyways, it'll show up in the picture. A yellow knit oversized long sleeve sweater in an extra small. I don't even remember what the brand. Oh, this was Jassy. I don't even know how to say that. It was J-A-A-S-S-E. E. Yeah, I don't, it was like, I pulled it up and there were lots of items under the name. I didn't recognize it. She also grabbed a Daytona Beach motorcycle short sleeve tee in a large and this really cool Western leather belt, silver buckle in green, and it was a size 25 to 28. So this belt, I thought it was like the coolest belt in the world. I paid up a little bit at Value Village for it, but I thought it was just so unique and I had a ton of likes on it, but people just didn't want to buy it. I even sent cool offers and I would bundle it in. Nah, they weren't doing it. So I was happy someone finally bought it. I thought it'd be perfect for her. Next was a bundle for $70. This was a 5-item bundle. It included a Dreamers oversized knit cardigan in small medium for $22. A white tan tie-dye hoodie medium sweater in medium. This one, the girls and I tie-dyed ourselves. We did them back in summer. A yellow lined puffer jacket in small. This was a thin line twick jacket and a purple tie-dye long sleeve scoop neck shirt in medium. And what was the brand on that one? It was a White Birch, so it was a boutique-y brand that I had never heard of. And then she also got this flowy leopard long skirt. I kind of threw it in for free, so it was an item that I purchased that I thought was super trendy and I thought it'd be cool, but apparently not everyone else did. And it took forever. It was like one of the first items we posted in our closet, and you can tell by the picture in the listing, because that was kind of how I did our listings in the beginning. A big bundle, and for $70, it was a good deal. The next one was an Under Armour blue hoodie in the large, and then another separate sale would have been these vintage mech polar fleece zip away pants, and they were in an XL. I think they were actually like a men's, but the legs were a short length, so they made me think that maybe they were women's. I'm not sure. They were so cool. They were just too big on me. I love mountains. I love hiking. We are a big snowboard and ski family, so usually if I come across any brands that I think the four of us will use or wear, I keep it. But these were just too big for any of us, so happy they went out. I hope this person is using them, enjoying the weather, and loving her vintage Mountain Equipment Co-op fleece pants. Next item to go out was a pair of Hollister Distressed Boyfriend Jeans. These were in a 28. They sold for $20. Also had a bundle for $50, and this was 2 items. I had a 10 Tree gray long sleeve sweater in large, and a pair of Skechers Grand Jams tall black boots in a 7.5. Both of them were bins items, so a bundle selling for $50 is nice. Up next, we have some Circus Sam Edelman black Highland studded boots. These were super cute, and they had a little bit of wear inside, but again, I was transparent with everything. I take good pictures. I make sure I'm noting this, and they sold for $27, and I think that was an offer to likers, because they were probably listed at $30, and if I'm sending offers to likers, I'm going to tell you guys at the end, because I want you to stick around till the end, and I'm going to tell you one of my little secrets for helping get sales without doing offers to likers, because I do send those out once in a while, but I have another method. It's not one that I've come up with. It is something that other Poshmarkers have already said, but I'll repeat it. All right, next bundle. This sold for $40. It was a Torrid maroon waffle knit top with a lace bottom. It was in a 1X. Very good condition. Super cute. And then I love the, this was awesome. You'll see in the picture. It's so cool. LL Bean pink corduroy long sleeve button down shirt in a 2X. It was cool. And if it would have been in my size, I would have kept it. Wasn't in my size, so I had to sell it. And I'm happy because I had quite a few likes on it, so I'm happy it went out. All right, next item up was a North Face purple hooded sweater in an XL. This was practically brand new. And here's the weird thing. I tried to list this item last month and it kept flagging it that it was like not copyright, but what the heck is it? It's like it was being reported as a fake. So basically, I don't even know, because I ended up dealing with customer service at Poshmark because I was so frustrated, and twice I tried to list the item and the item wouldn't show up in my closet. It would give me a message saying there was something wrong with my listing, and there was nothing wrong. I just took really good pictures of it. Anyways, when I contacted Poshmark, I had already deleted the ad and tried to relist it and deleted it again, and she said she didn't know why it was doing that, but maybe to take different pictures, like do a close-up or something rather than what I was trying to use. And I had it as like the North Face. I don't know. If you've ever had experience with that, can you drop a comment and let me know what you think or why you think it was happening? The only thing I could think of is they either thought it was a fake or they thought I was using copywritten images, which I wasn't. I was taking my own. I don't know. All right, next item, another fur collar denim trucker jean jacket. This one was in a small. It was also a little bit of a shorter fit where the other jacket was a longer one. Super cute. Wasn't even a brand name. I can't remember. It was either Blue Notes or from Urban Planet. It was something like a mall brand. And she bought that for $30. I had listed it at $30 and I think she just straight purchased it. Didn't even try and do a deal with me. Next up was a bundle. It was a two item bundle. Now, this did not sell for what I was hoping it would sell for, but I was happy to have it move. So sometimes I let items go for a really good deal because I just hate sitting on inventory. To me, it's like sitting on money. And this purse I paid up for. So as long as I was making some profit, I was okay with selling it at a lower price. I had been sitting on it for 2 months and I don't like to sit on him. If you come shop in my closet, if you take a look at my prices, if you've ever sent me an offer, you learn real quick. I don't like to sit on items. I will take reasonable offers almost always. Our posh closet has only had items in it since June 7th. So everything in here is selling in less than, I don't know, July, August, September, October. So 4 months. So the other item that sold in this bundle was an RDS long sleeve zip up knit sweater in a large. For the $87, I'm gonna be happy. That was kind of like buying the purse and then maybe paying $7 for the sweater. Whatever, I will take it. I just wanted to get it out of my closet. Next bundle that sold was an oversized Sherpa Teddy long sleeve cardigan in a small slash medium. It was, I think the size actually said extra large on this, but I tried it on and it just kind of felt snug on me. So I was like, no way, this is not an extra large. This definitely fits like a small medium. And then she got a Molly Bracken green teal knit sweater. This was a medium large. It was sized as a medium large, which I thought was really different because not often do you get sweaters that are sized as like small medium or medium large, whatever. Anyways, it was super cute. I had a lot of likes on this item, so I was happy it went. And she also got a pair of Lululemon black tights in a size 10. I listed these black tights and I had so many people send me local offers and I was like, really? Come on. They're Lululemon. They were Wonder Unders, I think. They definitely were not the Align, which I know is the desirable one. I listed them at $45, which I thought was a very reasonable price for our Canadian closets. And yeah, I was just getting like crazy lowballs. So I thought, no, this is a pair of tights. They're black. People are going to want them. I'm just going to wait till a good offer came in. And I'm happy I did because she grabbed them. Actually, I think all three of those items came from the bins. It was a pretty good net profit. The next pair was a vintage men's lined Adidas black track pants in large. These pants, when I brought them out and I showed my husband, he was like, no one is gonna pay for those. Those are old. They're like ugly. I'm like, no, but they're vintage. Like they're super cool. Anyways, I listed them and I literally had this guy, and I would say a kid, like to me in the picture, he looked like he was not out of high school. And he was like, can you send me better pictures? Is there a deal? Anyways, I pulled the item out of the bag because I had already taken pictures listed, putting it in an inventory bag. And I noticed that there was two burn holes in the front. I was like, ugh, oh my gosh, I can't believe I missed this. It happens sometimes when I'm listing things, I'm going through it and I miss. So I messaged him back through the bundle because I put in a bundle. So anytime I'm doing messaging about sizing, fits, quality, blah, 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 I'm always gonna do it in a bundle. I never keep the comments on the listing. 90% of the time, I flag the comment to get it off and then I'll take the conversation into a bundle. So for this one, I was like, listen, I'm so sorry. I didn't realize there was two burn holes. Here's some better pictures. Here's also pictures of the hole. He was like, nope, it's all good. I'm buying them anyways. Thank you so much. I actually think that these were sold to maybe someone in my city because I literally put them in the mail that night at say 7 o'clock and he had them next day by supper. So the only thing I could think of was that he had to have been in my city, which is the first sale I have made in my own city, Saskatoon. Super excited. He actually sent me a message. I think he sent me a love note or he commented in the bundle and said, thanks. The pants were awesome. Exactly what I wanted. Perfect. Happy customer. Next item to sell was a pair of Torrid black jeggings. These were in a 16 tall. I listed these at 30, I believe, and she paid 27. They were in next to new quality. So I was not surprised. I got that dollar. I felt like it was very fair value. I've always said this. I try not to mark up my plus size stuff. I know that's one of the complaints people that buy plus size clothing say. These items I got the bins, so I was happy. She was happy. She loved them. Next item to sell was another bundle, and this This was a pair of Kenneth Cole black leather ballet flats in an 8.5 and an Ernest & Kelly orange long sleeve sweater in large. The ballet flats I thought actually were super nice. I was kind of sad that they weren't in my size because I think I would have kept these. The Ernest & Kelly orange sweater, I'm actually having reseller regret. I think I should have kept this sweater. It was so cool. Like the little baubles that were all over it, just had me in the feels. So many likes, so many people messaging me and saying, they would like it. I would put it in a bundle for them, and then they would message in the bundle. They're like, I'm so sad that this isn't in my size. So I'm sad. We're all sad. We all wish we could have wore this sweater. It was gorgeous. Next item was a pair of Harley Davidson silver studded heel ankle boots in a 7.5. I paid up for these as well. Like, I think I got them at Value Village and I was a little disappointed. I thought they would sell. Everyone's like, Harley Davidson boots sell. But I think it was the styles. I also listed these on eBay and they weren't selling on eBay either, which I was kind of shocked. So I definitely will stick with chunky heel and I'll go with the moto boot if I see them again. So we only have maybe 5 or 6 more bundles. So this was a bundle that was sent out. It sold for $43. It included a leather strap mesh vegetable tan grocery bag. This was really cool. It was kind of like organic, like the bag was organic. The mesh yarn was vegetable dyed and the leather was vegetable dyed. It was super cool. I just don't have a purpose for it, so I threw it in the closet. It was in new condition. Like, maybe the person bought it thinking they would, just like I have bought mesh bags with the hopes that I would use them, and I don't. And the other item that sold was an Eileen Fisher merino wool alpaca short sleeve sweater in a large. This sweater, so this was my first Eileen Fisher item that I've ever found, and since then I've now found 3 more. It was pretty cool, just maybe not a style that I would normally wear, otherwise I probably would have kept it. But here's the kicker. I sold a TNA gray kind of style sweater yesterday, I think, and I was going through my inventory to find it. And it wasn't there. And then I was like, this looks really similar to that Eileen Fisher sweater. And I went to the bin where the Eileen Fisher sweater was, and it was still there. So I sent the wrong item to this person, and I was so sad. Anyways, it was all good. I messaged her and said there was a shipping mishap and that the item was out for delivery yesterday, so she hadn't received it. And I was like, I'm so sad. I can't believe I sent you the wrong item. I'm so sorry. I have your address. I'm gonna send the right sweater tonight, which I did. I sent it out yesterday. Just keep the one that you received, which kind of sad because it was an Aritzia TNA sweater that was really nice and would have sold, but whatever, it's not worth paying shipping to come back to turn around and sell it, right? Anyways, she said she was having a day and completely understood how I made the mistake and not to worry, and that she's gonna treat it as a surprise package. Because she has no idea what the sweater looks like that I actually sent her. I hope she loves the item. And her Eileen Fisher sweater is in the mail. It's coming to you. I sent you the tracking number. All right, so next bundle to sell was 2 pairs of shoes. So one was a Coach Barrette lace-up sneaker in a size 6. And then also a pair of Tommy Hilfiger black heather tall riding boots. This bundle sold for $48, which was a little bit lower than I would have wanted to sell it. But I'm learning that the resale value on Poshmark for Coach shoes actually isn't that great. I took it, I accepted it, both the items I felt like I'd been sitting on for a little bit, and I was happy to kind of keep them moving. I knew, so this is the other thing, I knew I was going to the bins last week, which would have been, this is the week before I went to the bins, so I knew, anyways, I knew I was going to the bins right away. So I want my inventory to move. I want to get things sold so that I have more room in my storage and in my inventory space to store what I got. And I knew that I was going on a 2-day bins haul trip because I live 5 hours away. It's such a long trip. I got 10 hours of driving. I've decided that when I go now, I'm going to make them a 2-day trip. And I have a girlfriend that lives in Edmonton that I can stay with. Long story short, they sold for less than I wanted. I took it as it was. Next was a bundle of 2 items. This was a mustard yellow cardigan 3/4 sleeve in an extra large and a vintage 90s knit long sleeve sweater in a large as well. This bundle sold for $35. I like vintage sweaters. And I'm so happy that they're in style right now and everyone else loves them because they're so cute. The next bundle that sold, this was a 5-piece bundle and it sold for $75. I had a Forever 21 yellow short sleeve t-shirt style bodysuit in a medium, pair of Levi's black 711 skinny distressed ripped jeans in a 26, a green waffle knit long sleeve top in medium, Aztec Western print shrug shawl, which I thought was super cute, happy she got that, and another top, a Banana Republic gray ribbed long sleeve top in medium. I know all these items were bin items. They were super cute and it was a great bundle, great colors, very fall vibes, and I think she'll have some cute outfits to put together. Next one was a pair of Guess LA Daredevil bootcut jeans in a 28. These sold for $17. I know bootcut jeans, they're just not the thing right now, but it's just not the style that people are mostly looking for. These also were not high-waisted. I would say they were low to mid. Happy with the $17 that I got for them. Next was a bundle. This was a bundle of 5 items and it sold for $80. I had a Frank and Oak black oversized zip-up cardigan in large. I had a Texas reverse tie-dyed short sleeve oversized tee. For this reverse tie-dye, this was another project the girls and I did. So we have a bin of items that kind of maybe have stains, aren't in great shape, that we throw everything in. And then probably like once every couple months, I do some reverse tie-dyeing with bleach. I love doing it. It's so much fun. My youngest loves doing it with me. We also have a bin of items that we're going to tie-dye. So anything that's white that we think would make a good tie-dye item, we throw into there. Most of the time it's my kids' clothes or myself. I like to wear tie-dye. Yeah, that was one that we did ourselves. And a vintage beach bum puppy white sweater in medium. This was so cute. Here's another tip. This had a little bit of yellowing around the collar. Anytime I get a white item, if I know that it's like not like stitched graphic, but like a stamp or like iron-on transfer kind of thing, I will actually bleach it. So I threw this shirt into the sink with a little bit of bleach, some water, and let it soak overnight. It whitens almost anything. We actually got a Versace shirt. It hasn't hit the closet because my oldest Lena took it. It was kind of yellowing and dingy looking, and threw it in the sink with bleach water overnight. Next day, crisp white. It's a beautiful shirt. She wears it out and about. I know that. The next item to sell was a black satin cami top in large and a denim long sleeve button down in an extra large. A great bundle. I always hope that people follow me on Instagram and they tag me in their outfits, and sometimes I'll like comment in their bundle. I'll be like, hey, FYI, come find me on Instagram. If you wear the outfit, can you just tag me in it? Because I'd love to see how you rock this. Yeah, I just want to see how people rock it, especially that Texas shirt. It's that cool kind of vintagey vibe. So we're down to the last two items that sold. This sold for $30. It was an Aritzia TNA Perfect Crew sweater in an XX small. I actually received a lot of lowball offers on this sweater, which I was like, no, this is a very trendy color. It is Aritzia, it is TNA. I am not letting this one go. And I'm happy because she paid my full asking price. The last item to sell was a pair of Sam Edelman black zip-up heel booties in a size 8. They sold for asking price as well. That's our week. There was a lot of items. Thanks for sticking it through and listening to everything as I go through. I'll put my phone down. As I promised, I want to share some tips. So these are my top 2 tips for increasing your sales. So number 1, take good pictures. Please take good pictures. If you can, on your cover shot, use any app that will white it out. I use Photo Room. You just put the picture in there. It deletes all the background. It turns it white. It looks so crisp. Check out my closet. The Urban Goddess. We are a Canadian closet. So if you are an American closet, just switch over to Canada. Check it out. Everything looks the same. Very nice. People shop easily. The other tip I have. So the one main tip, what I was talking about with the bundles. So I don't send out a lot of offers to likers. If I send offers to likers, I also have to give a shipping discount, and especially when items are only selling, you know, for under $25 or even $20, I really don't want to discount it plus give shipping discount, because then you're just not making a lot of money off the item. I follow the person and I toss it in the bundle. Then I can send them an offer. So I usually send them an offer for 10% off. This is for a single item. I already have it set in my closet. If you buy more than 2 items, I'm giving you a 20% discount. Another thing you can do, if you're going to send offers to likers and you're going to take a discount on shipping anyways, why not set a dollar value and say, hey, if you spend $70, I will give you $9.99 shipping. I have a set dollar amount that I will say, if you spend this much, I will give you $9.99 shipping. It's something that's achievable. So usually if people purchase at minimum 2 items, they're not only going to save 20%, but they're also going to get a shipping discount. When I look at my total single sales, I had 16 sales that were single, but I had 16 sales that were bundle sales. If I sold 60 items, those 16 bundles accounted for a lot of the items. And I know that usually people message me, so they'll comment in the bundle and they'll be like, hey, thanks for the heads up. I'm gonna keep looking. Now, trust me, there are a ton of people that don't purchase anything else, that don't even make the purchase or take my 10%, which is cool. I get that. For the amount of people that do turn that into a bundle and purchase one or two or four more items, it is worth doing it. Don't get caught up in offers to likers. Try creating bundles. See what happens. I wish you all the best. Happy poshing. If you like reseller content, give me a thumbs up. If you want to hear more and you want to follow our journey on reselling, make sure you hit subscribe. You can also tap that little bell, which gives you the notifications, and then you'll always catch our videos right when they come out. All right. Well, thanks for tuning in. Happy poshing and have a wonderful week. Bye.